Hi, everybody. Welcome back to our video course on rapid wireframing. My name is Billy Carlson. I'm a design educator here at Balsamiq. In this video, I'm going to explore mobile design for two key screens, the restaurant listing and the restaurant menu. So the first thing I want to do is actually switch back to the sketching style. And you're going to go to Style, Sketch, and then you're going to go to Font and go back to Balsamiq Sans. Hopefully I didn't mess up too much. Everything looks pretty good from here, but the reason why I want to do that is this style is easier for me to be more creative and more exploratory in, and the other style is meant for having a more polished visual design for a presentation with a stakeholder or a client or something you would show a user in a usability test. So let's get started. The way I've designed this entire application lends itself really well to different screen sizes, and that was intentional. I have a lot of experience designing for multiple sizes, so how I do this is I create patterns that I know will scale up or down depending on the width and height of a screen. As you can see, our assets for iOS in here give us this nice iPhone Chrome. A Chrome would be this outside visual representation of a newer iPhone model, right? Again, it's super easy, but all I have to do is maybe grab this and drag it over. That's step one. Step two would probably change this design, right? I don't need to have it say cart. It'll live up here. This is sort of your nav area. Just a quick iOS lesson. Here up top is your nav bar. Any items up here would be your navigating on a specific screen. So in this design, all I'm going to do is actually remove the word cart. It's sort of already set up to be a cart. Right now, we don't need our back button. And the next thing I'll do is probably just take these designs and slide them over. Now I'm just going to select these main boxes. And because this one is grouped, it's going to stretch everything. I'll just show you to demonstrate. These aren't changing, obviously, what this is. So what I can do is it's fine because this content is great. Just the logo got stretched. So I can just ungroup it. But what I want to do is have that same width here, however long that is. It seems to work well. So I'll just draw another rectangle similar to my other design, right? And I'll just do dark gray twice. And now I want it to be behind the logo, but not be behind anything else. So I have to select all the layers. So this black box is selected, this container, and now the phone. And I'll hit the send back. And now I have this right here. Okay. And I'll just put that in the center, add some height to it. Okay. All right. So I just made some small updates to try to make it bigger for this mobile size. And now if I zoom out, overall, I think it looks really good. And so now that I have this design here, for mobile, I want to see what my alternate design option looks like as well. So I will just go here to alternate. I'm going to use Command or Control and hit the A key, then hit the C key. I selected everything essentially, and then I copied it. Now I'm going to go to the official version. Again, I want to reiterate that I've designed this so that it would easily translate into mobile, just based on its design. So I selected everything. I'm going to deselect the imagery because the imagery will get squished, but then just squeeze it in there, right? So one thing I wanted to show you all too is right now I'm keeping the design pretty much contained into this rectangle or whatever. But how I work on mobile applications when there's a lot of different content, especially like right now, this is designed to be a very simple pattern. Other screens will have more options. What I actually do is I'll draw a rectangle here and just extend it down like this. And then I will send it to the back. So it has this look to it. An easy way to get rid of this is just to crop it. So what I can do is by adding something else. So I draw this rectangle. I can sort of make it cheat, draw another rectangle, but this one I'll just make a white border so you can't see it, right? If I make this a group, I can then crop off that top area and use the rest for my fake canvas. And this is how I add more space to a mobile phone and show that it extends below. I can just keep adding restaurant logos, right? I'll just copy and paste these. And now I can crop this bottom one to sort of show that that's where it stops. And this is just one way to present lots of data on a mobile screen. And I can see it's extremely easy. If you think about your design, plan ahead, you can create something that works well on a big, you know, iPad screen or on a phone or anything in between. Let's take this screen and turn it into mobile too. So the first thing I'll do is maybe copy these over. I copied it, hit Control C, and look at that, pasted it right in place where I want it. I guess I need the back button as well. And just hold on to the Option key to make a copy. Now it's in the same, the way I dragged it, you can see these three lines show that it's in the same sort of horizontal row that I want it to be in. The next thing is I will probably change this from these dark colors to something outside of the colors and just have it like this. This would be our category navigation here, and I could add another one to show that it slides off. But if you remember from the previous screen, we want to zoom out and probably be as big as this. So as big as 18, just select 18. And we have to make these wider now. Let's just space it out a bit. And now what I can do is, because it's just text, I can close a text box. And it looks like it's coming off the page a bit, but it's really just closing the text box. The next thing I want to do is add a few other elements to make it separate, similar to this, but separate the content in this more confined area. So I have featured. And what I'll do is I'll use the slash key on my keyboard and type in H-O-R, horizontal line, or H rule, which will help me add this separator. What it does is it makes this one section and this is another section. Another thing I can do to help with that is just changing this typeface to be slightly lighter. Now I have a top area and I have my categories that you can swipe through. And this would be the beginning of the menu. Oh, I forgot to put my name here. So in iOS, it's pretty common to have your name in this title section. And it looks good. Okay, so now highlight it, hold on to Option, and then just drag it to my new canvas. One thing I wanted to do here is change these to just $24. Now I'm going to hit the Command D key. Typically on a website, 16 would be the smallest font size we'd want for accessibility. That's for body copy. For descriptor copy, I'm making it a little smaller. There's a lot of spacing here, so I don't need all that spacing on mobile. That's why I have these in their own boxes. That's where all the spacing is going to happen. I would probably just continue the same design pattern below, but start using the categories. Okay. That's a nice, easy way to make a mobile design. One thing I want to do is maybe add a separator here. So this is my navigation area. This is a swipeable category selector. And then this is just the menu. So if I tapped on this, I'll add an H rule. Pretend I tapped on thin crust pizza. I would put some sort of indicator that I've selected it. And this would basically just move up and it'd just be filtered, right? It's like a quick filter. It makes it easy for me to shop and choose. Okay, and now again, like I said, if I back out, I hit small and I hold my phone up, I can read everything on the screen pretty easily. And the most prominent things on the screen are right here. I can increase the hierarchy here by adding color or something, but because of its placement on the screen, I believe most users will know exactly where to find the cart. So I'm not worried about making it jump out in your face, because if I was looking to check my cart, I would go to the top right corner or look for it, and there's no tabs at the bottom. Okay, let's do the other alternate screen now too. And all I'm going to do is hit Control A, Control C, go back to the alternate, or the official version, I should say. Drag this out again, and I will paste it up here and just take a look. Okay, so this one's pretty interesting because we want to introduce something like search. We want to have these three elements at the top of the screen, or we can do search right here and as like a main feature. So let's try that first. And again, I'm going to zoom in, but right now, if you look at this size, if this was real size, this search bar is pretty tiny, right? So we have to make it a lot taller, probably something like that. So now that would be the minimum I would want to tap into. And I think that's a good rule for you to notice when designing. How big things need to be on a mobile screen. That does take up a lot of space, so it makes me change exactly how I'd want to design it. Maybe I will keep this in the center too. Just make it bigger so people know what restaurant they're at. And now I would have to add the back button, but maybe this time I'll just have the icon. I'll just make it bigger so that it's easier to see. And I'll do the same thing for the cart. So I'll just take this, hold on to the option key and bring it over. Try to get it sort of centered with the other one. I want to have this blue because something is in the cart now and we want to visually show that. We'll just make it bigger. Okay. Give it some space. And now we have the search. And what we have to add now is this section here. I could probably actually select two of these and that, and then hold on to shift, bring it over. Because again, it's smaller, we need to make everything bigger. Now I have more room to work with, but I don't think we necessarily need to make it that much bigger. As long as we can read it at the small size. I'm sort of setting it up here to know how much space I have here. So it stands out against the color a bit. Hold my phone up to it. It's a little smaller than my phone. Okay, it's a little small. I want to bump this up and make these bigger. So I went ahead and created this alternate version, which I like just as much. I can also, if I wanted to, add this up top. So why don't I see what that looks like? This is a bit more of like an Android pattern, which is still nice, right? Have everything the tops have an icon that would then create an action afterwards. And I'll just use this. So let's do 24 by 24. And so I typed in 24, tab 24, and then the escape key, and then I can move it around. It's a really quick way to use the inspector panel. Right now, I'd say this is where I'm at. Pretty good. This is a bit more of an Android design, which I like. Now you've seen a few options, and also how you can customize your kiosk tablet design to then shift to a mobile application, or say you're inside the food hall and you just have them go to a specific website where they can order there. And then if you zoom out, you hold your phone up to it, make sure it's the same height, you can easily and quickly check the text size in the content so that it's not too small. Pretty cool. Okay, that's it.